What up, y'all? Appreciate you showing up, hanging out. This is the man. Like and subscribe. So, another bad news for Sony. I can't make this up. It's like, I can't explain how this generation is the opposite of PlayStation 4. The only thing that they are riding on right now is the momentum of last generation. They have done very little this generation to keep it going. They're slowing down. There's a bunch of roadblocks and obstacles in their way, and they're hitting every one of them. Boom, boom. They're like Homer Simpson falling off the mountain, hitting every tree, going down. Was that the... I don't remember what if that was the actual reference that I wanted to pull, or if it was even accurate. But it doesn't matter. The PlayStation VR 2 is not compatible with PlayStation VR 1 games. How in 2022, where you have an already sizable install base of at least 5 million PlayStation VR 1 customers, would you do this? I mean, it's kind of a simple answer. Simple answer is $10 upgrade. Now, will the PlayStation VR 2 games or the PlayStation VR 1 games be $10 upgrades? Or maybe $5 upgrades, and then they can say, look at the value we're providing, only $5, only. Jim Ryan likes to use the word only. They're only giving us 3 years, only $10, only $5. I don't make this stuff up. I just see it and I say it to you guys. And this is, it's like, wow. It's like they're not even trying to be the good guy. They're just like, we don't care. I mean, if you can't see it, then you got some kind of, you got Stockholm something? I don't know. It looks like an abusive relationship to me. You know, just not caring. Just sitting there slapping you upside the head. Bap, bap, bap. And you're going to like it. You're going to like what we give you. Because we're Sony and we're number one. We can do no wrong. Everything they're doing is wrong. So, man, imagine that. He's like, yeah, man, I'm getting PSVR 2 and all the other games are going to play better because PSVR. Only if they decide to patch. They have to patch the games. Will they do the patches for free? Do we have to even go down that road? No, of course not. Of course not. They're going to charge you $10 for a next-gen upgrade, which is just like, oh, that version's already made because we made a PlayStation 5 version and a PlayStation 4 version. We're just charging you more arbitrarily. Same product. You just have different machines and you're penalized for having the new machine. So now PlayStation customers, PlayStation VR 2 customers are penalized for buying the new headset. Makes no sense. Also, I was listening to the CADcast and they were explaining, well, Cheapy, you know, he's ping pong. He's a ping pong master. He's not a master. He's a ping pong addict. I think that's more accurate. And he was explaining, I think Wombat was explaining that the PSVR 2 is trash for ping pong VR games because of the tether. Because it's tethered. That's why the Oculus Quest, Meta Quest, whatever, Meta Quest 2, that's why that's ideal because it's all self-contained. It's all self-contained unit, no wires. So you can play VR, ping pong, table tennis, no problem. You gotta move around. That's the whole point. If you're tethered in the back of your head or wherever the wire comes out, that's a no-go for a lot of games. And even with the technology that the PSVR 2 has, the inside-out tracking, which is helpful, the tether hinders that technology because what it does is the inside-out tracking, it'll, you're in the room, you can do a sweep of the room and it'll give you the barriers, the walls and tables and all that stuff. I mean, I'm not sure if PSVR 2 does this, but I believe the Quest does this. And it creates a space based off of whatever room you're in. And that works if you're wireless. But if you're wired, you're tripping. Maybe, possibly, it's more hazardous. You know, people are clumsy anyway, so it's not a good look because, you know, you think about, you know, this is going to be lawsuits. Why the wire trip is unsafe? I can't. I'm suing. I don't know. It's just goofy. And then I was watching Spawn Wave. I think it was Spawn Wave. And he was like, I just wanted to let you guys know, you know, for the sticker shock of this thing. People were saying, oh, it's going to be $399, $500. Now they're saying $600. I'm like, what? Okay. That's a lot of money. And yeah, probably because they literally raised the price of the PlayStation 5. Unprecedented. They did it. So yeah, I'm gonna say 500. So that the PlayStation 5 actually looks like a more impressive machine, because it is, because the PlayStation VR 2 is just a headset with there's some power in there because it has to push the resolution on the screens, but there's no compute power as far as running apps and games. It's all plugged. That's why you got a wire. So unless they're gonna do some magic and say, oh, $399, that would be ideal. But in this world that we live in today, where Sony is charging up the yin yang for anything, nah, they're gonna get as much money as they can out of that thing, and they're not gonna make that many of them. So they're gonna have false scarcity, and they're gonna jack up the price, which will reinforce the false scarcity, because people will be like, oh, there's not a lot, so people will buy them because, you know, FOMO and all that. It sounds like a plan. If I was a businessman only concerned about making money, that's what I would do. Because it's like, okay, I mean, honestly, if you look in the past of video games, Nintendo kind of did that a little bit. They also did some some kind of not nice things, evil, shady practices, Nintendo. I mentioned this before. I do want to do a little bit more research, but from what I remember, they were buying back stock of their, I don't know if it was games or if it was the actual console. It was the NES. I think it was during the NES era, to boost sales, to boost what the sales looked like for, I guess, for, I don't know if it was for investors. I think it was just, you know, whatever. So, like I said, I need to do more research on that. But the whole Splatoon thing, real quick tangent, the Splatoon 3 sold 3 point something million in 3 days. I'm like, that's a lot. And I know there's a lot of Switches out there, but that's a lot. That's a lot. So once I heard the story about what Nintendo did in the past, I'm like, are you sure they're still not doing that? You know? And then that leads me to Sony. I was like, are you sure Sony's not doing a little bit of that too? You know? They say, okay, well, we're going to allocate, I don't know, 5 million units for, you know, repair and replace or whatever. Put that in a warehouse. We count those as sold. Mm-hmm. Boost the numbers real quick. Mm-hmm. I mean, if everybody did it, then it's fine. But I don't know. I don't know what the deal is. So, yeah, that's just, you know, a little bit of conspiracy sprinkles on there for y'all. But yeah, I mean, let me know in the comments, what y'all think about this PSVR not being backwards compatible? It's ridiculous. That's not the world we live in anymore. And Sony is still pushing that. Pushing that generations. We believe in generations. They're reinforcing the fact that they don't believe in generations. Or the fact that they are separating the generations mean that they do in a stupid, weird way. You know what I mean? Kind of in a bass-ackwards way, if you will. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, you could say, yeah, they believe in generations. That's why you can't play the old generation on new generation, because the new generation is better. But it's like, okay, I get that. But that's not good. That's not a good look for consumers. The bottom line is, Sony has been doing everything antithetical. I like to use, I've been using that word a lot, sorry. Anti-consumer. They have been anti-consumer this whole generation, and they continue to do that. And hopefully that behavior will allow something like the Activision Blizzard King deal on the Microsoft side to pass through without a hitch. I think this is just, you know, like I said, they're just trying to throw some monkey wrenches into the machine, but you know, their behavior all this generation is exactly what they're trying to fight against when it comes to Microsoft and this deal. And it's hypocrisy straight up. And like I said before, if the CMA, they are siding with Sony, but if they block it or they do something, then I know that it's just corruption. You know, it's just like, please, they've been doing it all generation and now it's an issue. And yeah, it doesn't make sense. But anyway, that's a whole other topic that we will continue to talk about, obviously, because it keeps happening. But anyway, let me know in the comments, are you guys gonna go get the PlayStation VR 2 if it's, let's say, $500? If it's five, would you get it? Given that it's not backwards compatible, it does Horizon Call of the Mountain, is that enough? It's not. I'll talk to you guys later again. Again, later, later again. That's way too many times.